Howdy folks, and welcome back. Let's play Pillars of Eternity, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon, where we last left off. It was last year, 2016, and we were exploring some catacombs. Now, however, it is 2017, and we are still exploring some catacombs. See, do we have anybody we can give this thing to? See, we could, in theory, give it to Durance, give some cold damage reduction, which compared to his cape might be worthwhile. I mean, it's better than what he has, so we'll give it to him. Hey, it's color even matches. Man, those cloth physics, that's like, I don't know. That's like, I think that might be some of Unity's canned cloth physics, which they're fun to play with, but I don't think they're really necessarily the best thing in the world. They're cool to kind of play around with though, because they have like built-in simulated tearing and stuff for the cloth. So like I'll just, you know, whoa, it's a troll. I'll just, you know, like place a cloth object in Unity and then like drape it over a bunch of cubes and see how it tears and stuff. It's kind of fun to just, like I said, just play with. But not too useful beyond that. And I was gonna say, go ahead and trip this thing, but don't need to. We got some troll skin. Delicious, delicious troll skin. We could probably rest, but meh. Okay, so we're pretty well done here. We have the Temple of Wodica, which I believe was our destination throughout all of this. And we apparently missed some loot. I really wish I could hold down shift and it would make the map scroll faster. I can't remember what game it was. There's some game I have played where that's the case, where, you know, you'd move the map around with W, or the camera around with WASD, but if you hold down shift, it moves substantially faster. And it's kinda handy. So what do we have here? Some ooze plasma. Alright, into the stash.
What?
So, have I used, where is it? Where's the field triage?
How are our casters looking?
Our casters actually, I would say, are still comfortable on spells. I thought Goldleaf had leveled. I thought she got to fifth level. Maybe I'm just going crazy. It might be, I think that might have been a Loth I was thinking of. I'm just gonna field triage these two. Give them a little healing that way. There, see, she's back up to positives. So, well, back up to green status, I should say. Good quick save here. Well, we'll go down. The red fill on a character's portrait represents the loss of endurance. I was tempted to implement that for Fiance game, but decided against it. I don't even remember what. Whoa! An older robed man. I wonder if this is the guy that we saw at the beginning of the game who was evil looking. In front of you looms the ghostly hollow image of a man who was present at your awakening. Uh-huh. He casts a pale, sickly light on the dank corridor as he regards you.
You are from Kratu, my boy.
His words are an echo in your mind from a time long past, and you know your response before you speak it, as if it has always been. Yes, I was born there.
A remarkable city. Truly one of the most impressive we have encountered outside of our own. Many exceptional people who have joined our cause come from Kratum. What made you decide to join our order?
Oh, God. I honestly do not know.
As long as you are assured in your faith, the rest is not so important. Are you ready to take the oath? To spread the word of the gods to the lost and heathen.
I am. Okay, that's certainly interesting. Half Makig and mercenary. All right, we're gonna leave them alone for the time being. So we have over here, if anything, a little side passage. I wonder if there's a secret door here.
Huh?
You know, what with the wall seams that are kind of obvious.
Found something.
Oh, hey, what's this? Oh, hey, it's a secret door. All right, Goldleaf, you go in first because there may be, yeah, there may be traps. Failed to disarm. Oh, Goldleaf, what is this? You think you hear the faint sound of whispering coming from the skulls, but the words are unintelligible. That's worrisome.
Finished.
All right, well, at least she got that one. Go ahead and loot that. See if there's anything good in here. Girdle of Mortal Protection. Properties, decrease critical hit damage. Nice. Shift that over. What else do we have? Rite of Ancient Legends, which we have now three of. And some gems. Nice. Okay, we'll just get out of here. Alright, well, we got a magic girdle. Well, we currently don't have a girdle on Swell, so now we do. System works. That's kind of cool. I like that they make it so you have to actually search to find the thing as opposed to it just being something you can randomly mouse over or whatever. I appreciate that little touch. The mercenary eyes you warily as you approach, his weapon readied. What are you doing here? You don't look like the one of the masked lot. Resolve 13, I left my mask inside. Let me pass. He thinks carefully, then nods. Alright. Alright then. Go on in, report to the Acolyte, and she'll give you your assignment. They should just be about finished with their meeting in the big chamber. Any idea what's going on around here? Word of advice, friend. Don't ask questions. Just go and do what you're told. Or anything about this place. He shakes his head. As far as I can tell, we're underneath fire. First fires. Probably under that ruined temple. Farewell. Alright, well, you know, we got through it without murdering them. However... yeah! See, that's the thing, is, you know, okay, we engage in these two in combat, and it's like, it's only two guys, there's six of us, we got this! And then these three come down and are like, hey guys, guess what? Fireballs! So, yeah, this is... possibly some trouble. Maybe I should. I am gonna rest. we will give her. I think I'm gonna give her damage reduction too. Go ahead and have her and Adair matched on that. Man, you guys know what I've been kind of getting a hankering to play recently? Fucking, of all things, Wizardry 6. I am not a huge fan of the Wizardry games. I think they are, in a lot of ways, pretty tedious to play. But damn, sometimes I just get in a mood and I will play through one of them and just have a blast with it. I shouldn't say that they're tedious. 7 and 8 were both really good games. Uh-oh. Aloth falters and brings a hand to his forehead. He takes a staggering step forward, coughing and sputtering.
Back here, Claude! Those hooded fiends are nigh to be trusted!
Elf, pull yourself together. He grimaces, catching his breath. It's nothing, I'm fine. He coughs again. This probably isn't the best place to linger anyhow. It's like it's a warning or something that we're gonna get ambushed. Now, I don't think that the... You hear murmurs and chants on the other side of the door. A ritual of some sort is already underway. However, your only means of disguise is presently in use. Retreat from the door. I want to save. Oh, it's gonna let me. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and quick save here. I do want to state, I don't think the later Wizardry games are bad. We are gonna go into the chamber, however. You open the door and stride into the chamber, motioning for the rest of your party to accompany you. We are stranded, like just kind of wandering in here, ass to the wind, swords drawn, ready to fuck shit up, probably get killed. Several shrouded figures are lined up across from a hooded woman. The figure at the head of the line approaches her, and the woman places her outstretched hand on the stranger's forehead. They stand in silent communion as you look on. A few moments later, the stranger steps aside and resumes his place in the circle beside the statue. All eyes in the room fall on you, and you hear quick, angry mutters being exchanged. Brothers, sisters, an intruder walks among us. Deal with him. Alright, so it's just shrouded men and women. See, there's fire there, that worries me. There's a spellcaster. I assume this is probably a cleric. So I'm gonna have everybody focus her down. Aloth, you are on the wrong side of this room. God, the music of this game is so good. Over here. What the hell is that? Maybe a monk or something? Just drop a fireball over there. Okay, Durance, get over here. Actually, both of you, get over here. Get out of melee. Drop a dire blessing. Gold Leaf, you're probably going to end up dead. Because you kind of always do. How's he looking after that fireball? Still pretty hale, I would say. There's my minute meteors. Alright, here, we'll try and sicken this guy. I just want to, like, fuck this dude up. I don't want him to be able to cast that. Fireballs and stuff. Durance is gonna die. Alright, so basically all of our casters are down. This is why I saved before I came in here, because I figured this was probably not the best idea. What I should have done is pulled everyone outside of the room and kind of fought them at the door. I wonder if I can maybe do that now. Alright, Adair's gonna, I think, get probably pasted here.
Big fella's down!
Yep. Big fella's down, I love it. Oh, Adair's not down. He's still in there beating the shit out of things. Oh, she is just so... It's gonna stand right there. Swell. It's an AoE, this is an AoE. From here? Can't tell. Yes. Yeah, Adair is in here, like, tanking four guys. Alright, so this is a mage. This dude needs to be, like, primary target here. I think we can probably do this fight. We just need to, not be an asshole about it. I know that's hard for me sometimes, but I think we can do it. Aha! There is a cleric in here, I knew it. I don't know which one of them you are. You're gonna have a bad time. Eat street, D-bag. We're going to... She's just like standing out here. Come in here and start stabbing things. With your obnoxious little yippy dog too. Let's see, Adair, just knock that asshole down again. Keep him on the floor where he needs to be. So you guys come around, start smiting. What do we have here? Sworn enemy. That's not, I don't think, worth it. So what do we have here? Shrouded Man. I'm just looking at their stats here really quick. All right, so this is like the tankiest of them all, but not by much. This guy is a little squishy. You can kind of tell just by looking at him, like these dudes are in plate mail and this guy's kind of in, actually similar to what Swell is wearing. So we're gonna go ahead and focus this guy down. Let's see if this actually works in like close melee. Yeah, these guys are... Was there another... Oh shit, this is another freaking healer. Alright, noted. So basically everyone that's not in plate mail is a healer. Heal Adair some more. Adair is in kind of a bad place right now, hit point wise. I'm gonna have him drink a potion of in... Well, no, there's only one of them left. I think we've probably got this. So this should, in theory, be like a life leech effect, I think. Maybe heal him a little bit. Yeah, look at that, man. I pulled that shit right out. I fucking pulled victory out of the jaws of absolute incompetence. Go me. Crumbled at your feet lies the body of a woman. She wears a dark robe that bears an insignia resembling a key. As you approach her body, feelings of rage assault you. The dead woman's voice howls in your ears and her lingering consciousness rends at yours. Her essence tingles through your bones and membranes. It fills the spaces between your ears and behind your eyes, clawing deeper into your core. You see a gathering of men and women wearing robes like hers, their faces hidden behind masks. One by one they approach her, whom they know as an acolyte. As she places her hand on their foreheads, searching their thoughts. She tests them with ritualistic questions and they answer that their oath is sealed by the leaden key. She asks them of their tasks, she gives them new ones all without a word. Well, let's see the tasks. Your essence flares, fighting to boil your, or her essence flares rather, fighting to boil your blood, burn your memory, and splinter your bones from within, yet between its strikes you see flashes of something else. A tower, a prisoner, and a ruin. You funnel all of your concentration into a single effort of will, a sharp point that pins the raging soul in place like an insect in a display case. With the thing under control, you're able to examine it and the three thoughts swirling inside. Let's look about the tower. You say a palimpsest? That's a new one of a neighborhood. Rundown estates are cobbled around a cemetery and an ancient tower. Savage shapes prowl the streets, and in the tower a man hunches over a strange mechanism. You can't see him clearly, but there's something unnatural about him. Somewhere nearby, you see a woman with a scar over her heart. You understand that she has something he needs. You also see a door at the base of the tower, a seemingly impenetrable slab of stone and copper, but then the acolyte reveals the invisible split between the perfectly matched halves, and you understand how the copper veins convert a command into action. You know how to open the door. Well, that's good. We figured something out. What about the prisoner? In your mind, you see a building, magnificent with trellises and tiles, and located on a pristine boulevard, of the wealthy and learned stroll in and out, trading knowledge and coin. Yet it only houses misery and madness. Somewhere within its rotten course, it's a man, his hair matted, but his eyes alert. He watches and waits, a prisoner by choice. And the ruins? The acolyte's vision takes you to Defiance Bay, or takes you out of Defiance Bay, into a town in the wilderness with a waterfall. A soundpost on one of the paths reads, Deerford. I think we're maybe supposed to be going there anyways. Several figures huddled together, shrouded in cloaks and hoods. The image of ruins suddenly looms in your mind. Two skeletal effigies flank a cleft in the mountainside. And we back away. Oh, man. I'm so freaking impressed that I managed to somehow miraculously survive that with basically the entire back half of my party dead. All right, so what do we have? Oh yeah. Fine great swords, that might be good for a dare. A fine scepter, possibly for Aloth. An office's grimoire, maybe for Aloth. We have a bunch of the Wodica hoods and some plate armor, which we'll take a suit. I don't think I'll probably be giving that to Swell, but it's there. Wow, a lot of coins and a lead key, which apparently auto goes into our stash. Okay, so everything else into the stash. So, this greatsword, what is he currently? Oh, that's right, he's using justice. So justice is better. So justice can go in the stash, and plate mail is DR12. I don't know, maybe I should give this to Swell. Yeah, because I mean, it's equivalent to what he has now, it's just not fine quality. Plus now he's like a proper paladin in plate mail and stuff. Can we enchant it by any chance? No. No, we can't. We need fungus or something. Pilgrim's crown. One of these days, you guys. One of these days. Okay, what do we have here? Whether by design or consequence of the sputtering candlelight, the hooded statue's face is almost impossible to see.
Mm-hmm.
A lever. Rather obvious. Probably opens this. I'm sure all of the other mercenaries and stuff floating around in here are now hostile to us. Devotees have placed assorted keys, their teeth filed away among the tunnels, or the runnels of wax. Alright, let's hit this. This is just to outside, I assume? You gonna show me on my map? No! Alright, well, I think I'm gonna probably clear this place for experience point reasons. Nothing too interesting there. But yes, I do want to clarify, as I was starting before we got into that whole thing, I don't think that this is what I was expecting. I don't think the Wizardry games are bad. They're just not to my tastes. Alright, so let's see here. I'm gonna do combusting wounds just on this door. Alright, and we're just gonna start throwing all kinds of holy lances through here. Oh, I can't! Oh, that worries me with those casters back there. Oh, alright. I'm just gonna slowly melee through it here. Here, come back this way. Adair's getting the hell beaten out of him. And apparently somebody is running a snowblower outside, and it is 5:30 in the morning, so whoever that person is, asshole. What is wrong with this door down here?
Let's go.
Okay, so the dog is charmed or something. We'll let it stay down there. I'm not worried. Where is she at? I was gonna say, that dog is like solo tanking this entire group of enemies. It's amazing. Alright, well, you guys wanna cast this? So can I. Love that they immediately go straight for my casters. Not particularly worried about it. Here, you fight him. Mark him as your prey. Little healing ray going here. There we go. A loth. Throw the book at him. Ha ha ha. What do we have back here? Kill this dude, guys. Come on now. I think that might just be a spellcaster. Oh, and Adair's back up with like 2 hit points and immediately goes down again. Why can I not go into this accursed room?
Ready, watcher.
Like, what is the problem here? It won't let me walk in there for some reason. I don't know what the deal is. But I don't think that the wizardry games are bad games. They're just not games that I'm probably ever going to let's play. Because they're, in a lot of ways, pretty tedious. Especially 8. 8 is my favorite one, but holy hell, the combat in that game is hellish later on. Not seriously, person. Go die. Adair, what are you? Ouch. You got screwed up. That's okay. We will just throw all this in our stash. And we will probably throw all of this in our stash. The wizardry games, like, if I were to play those, I'd probably do like what I'm doing with Might and Magic 2 and stream them, where I can sit and like play them for hours at a time. Because as a let's play, it would not be fun. But we are at 21 minutes here, so I think I'm gonna call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. We managed to freaking pull victory out of the jaws of utter defeat. And next time we're gonna clear this place out, because I'm sure there's loot in addition to XP floating around here. And it should be a good time. Until then.